Good morning, students.
Welcome to your science class. Let's start our chapter. Chapter number 12. Name of the chapter is Reproduction in Plants. The topic which we cover in this chapter are What is reproduction? Mode of reproduction, asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction, pollination, fertilization, formation of fruits and seed. And the last one is seed dispersal. Let's start our chapter. As we all know, all living things reproduce more of their own kind. The process through which a living organism produces new living organism or their young ones like itself is called reproduction. Or we can say reproduction is a process of production of new individuals from their parents. Reproduction is the only process which allows living organism to continue to live on the earth from one generation to the next generation. Now come to the type of reproduction. Reproduction in plants occur in two ways. First one is asexual reproduction and the second one is sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, plants are produced without using the seed. In this process, generally, the vegetative parts, that is, the leaves, stem, and roots are involved. But in sexual reproduction, the new plants are produced with the help of seed of a plant. In this process, the reproductive parts, that is, the flower of the plants, participate in reproduction. Plants have two different kind of parts to perform different method of reproduction, that is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. First one is vegetative parts. Vegetative parts are the parts of the plant that play a major role in the life cycle of a plant, such as preparation of food, transportation of food and water and nutrients, etc. For example, leaf, stem and roots. These are the vegetative parts of plant that help in preparation of food, that is leaf, and transport of food, water and mineral. Now come to the second part, which is reproductive parts. Reproductive parts are the parts of a plant that play a major role in the reproduction process in plants. For example, flower and fruits. In this video, we will discuss about asexual reproduction. In plants, there are different types of asexual reproduction. They are vegetative propagation, budding, fragmentation, and spore formation, etc. These are the four types of asexual reproduction or different modes of asexual reproduction, which we will discuss in detail in this video. Firstly, we will discuss about vegetative propagation. As the name suggests, this is the type of reproduction take place with the help of vegetative part. Vegetative part of plant. Only one person can produce the identical offspring in vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation can take place naturally and can also be carried out by artificial means. Firstly, we will discuss about vegetative propagation by natural means. First one is vegetative propagation by stem, as shown in this figure, or potato. Let's take this picture. Like stem tuber. Just like tuber's root, some plants have tuberous stems. These stem tubers store the nutrients and bear nodes, as you can see in this picture. These are the nodes, or we can say eyes. These nodes bear buds that form a new plant. Example, potato. Second type of natural vegetative propagation is vegetative propagation and root. We can take the example of sweet potato. Plants that have tuberous roots, that is, what is the meaning of tuberous is roots which are used as a storage organ in plants, participate in vegetative propagation. Tuberous roots are simply that can store food. Yes, storage organ of plant. In order to grow new plants, these tuberous roots are sown in soil. There are buds present in roots or present on the fruits that grow above the ground. And new plants is formed. As you can see, these are the buds. When they grow above the ground, they develop into a new plant. This is the old stem. This is the old stem. And these buds grow above the ground and form the new buds or new shoots. You can easily perform this by sowing a sweet potato in a soil. After some time, they can grow above the ground. Third one is vegetative propagation by leaves, as in bryophyllum. As in bryophyllum leaf, you can see. Some plants have leaves that contain buds that can develop into a new plant, as you can see in bryophyllum leaf. As you can see in this leaves, these are the buds which can develop into a new plant. Some plants grow along the ground and contain modified stems called runners. These runners contain tubers that can produce roots and stem, like in case of grasses, strawberries, etc. This is the example of runners. Now come to the artificial means of vegetative propagation. These are diagrams of artificial means of vegetative propagation. To perform vegetative propagation artificially, we have two different methods. First one is cutting, and the second one is grafting. In cutting, it is the method in which a cutting from a plant is taken and planted. This cutting is a part of stem or root or the branch of plant. Example, as in case of rose. This is the diagrammatic representation. This is the cutting from stem, and this is the cutting of root. They develop into a whole new plant. From one plant, you get two new plants. Now come to the second method, which is grafting. Sometime, two plants are joined together so that both of them can provide the desired characteristics to the new plant. One plant remains rooted in the ground, which is called stock. Which plant is attached with ground is known as stock, and it provides the essential nutrients and water from the soil, while the other plant stem is attached to it. This stem from other plant is attached to rooted plant. In this way, a new plant develops. Example, apples. What is the importance of vegetative propagation? Let us discuss about advantages of vegetative propagation. The plants that are produced with vegetative propagation grow faster than those that are produced with sexual reproduction. And the second advantage is the plant that reproduce with vegetative reproduction have fruits and flowers ahead of time. And the third advantage is the plants that are produced have exactly the same characteristics as that of their parents, because there is no mixing of other character. Now come to the second mode of asexual reproduction, which is budding. Yeast is an organism that contains a single cells. Yeast is a fungus, not a plant. It can propagate every few hours if the proper amount of nutrients are available to it. As the yeast find favorable condition, a small bulb-like projection produced from the yeast parent cell. These bulb-like projections are known as bud. The bud grow in size and then get detached. It grow and get detached from the parent yeast, and two cells are formed from a single cell. These new cells then grow, measures and produce more cell. Sometime a chain of buds is formed, which leads to the production of large number of yeasts together. So this is budding. Now come to the third method of asexual reproduction, which is fragmentation. Algae like Spirogyra generally reproduced by the process of fragmentation, in which they divide themselves into multiple parts. As soon as the algae find enough water and nutrients or the favorable environment, it fragments and grow into new individuals. This process continues and algae multiply quickly in a short period of time. As they grow, as they find favorable condition, they also fragmented into two parts, develop into another whole organism, or simply we can say in fragmentation, adult organisms breaks into two or more pieces and form a new individuals called fragments. This is the adult organism, which is fragmented into two or more fragments and form new individuals. Best example is Spirogyra. It is an algae. Now come to the fourth method of asexual reproduction, which is spore formation. Some plants contain spores that float in air and cause asexual reproduction. A spore has a hard covering which protect it from the unfavorable environment or harsh conditions like temperature and humidity. As a result, the spore can travel long distance and survive for a long duration of time due to the presence of hard covering. As soon as they find favorable conditions such as moisture and nutrients, they germinate and form new plants. For example, fungi. Most of the fern and mosses propagate in this way. So this is all about asexual reproduction and their different modes of asexual reproduction. Now come to the classwork. Your classwork contains 3 questions. First one is, what are the different methods of asexual reproduction? Give examples. So the different methods of asexual reproduction are, first one is vegetative propagation. As we all know, vegetative propagation is the ability of plant to produce new plants from vegetative parts of plant. Vegetative propagation is of 2 types. First one is natural vegetative propagation and second one is artificial vegetative propagation. Now come to the second method of asexual reproduction, which is budding. Budding involve the formation of new individual from bulb-like projections, known as buds. And the example is yeast. And the third type of asexual reproduction is fragmentation. Most common example of this type of reproduction is Spirogyra algae. In this type of asexual reproduction, new organisms is formed from the fragment of parent body. And the fourth one is spore formation. Many non-flowering plants reproduce through spore formation. Spores are tiny cells protected by a thick wall. Fungi such as bread molds reproduce asexually with this method. So these are the different methods of asexual reproduction. Now come to the second question, which is, explain what you understand by sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is the process which involves the production of seeds in plant. It requires 2 parents. Most plant reproduce sexually with the help of flower. Through this process, new organisms are produced which are almost similar to their parents. So this is sexual reproduction. Now come to the third question, which is, sketch the reproductive parts of flower. So this is the, just a minute. This is the female reproductive part of flower, and sorry, this is the male reproductive part of flower. The male and female reproductive parts of flower we will discuss in our next video or next lecture. So the female reproductive part is stigma, style and ovary. These three structures are involved in female reproductive part, but in the male reproductive part only two parts are involved, which is anther and filament. Details of male and female reproductive parts are discussed in we will discuss in next video. Now come to the homework. Your homework also contain three questions. First one is, state the main difference between asexual and sexual reproduction. I hope you can write the difference between sexual and asexual reproduction very easily. Now come to the second question, which is of matchings. Match items in column 1 with those of column 2. You have to choose the correct option from column 2, which is related to this, this and this, like buds are involved, are matched or involved in which from this, like yeast is an example of budding, so it is matched with yeast. You have to match the correct option, simply matchings. Now come to the third question, which is of MCQ type. First MCQ is, a spore producing plant is, you have to choose which one of these is a spore producing plant. Rose, bread molds or fungus, potato and ginger. You have to choose the correct option, which is a spore producing plant. Second MCQ is, bryophyllum can be reproduced by, the reproductive method which is used by bryophyllum. You have to choose the correct option. Bryophyllum reproduce by stem, roots, leaves and flower. You have to choose the correct option. So this is your homework. I hope you all understand what we discussed in this video. Thank you.